Are you looking to smash your opponents at the next standard event, poison your foes in Pauper, or empty libraries in Eternal formats? No matter what way you prefer to vanquish the foul, you'll find the tools you need at channelfireball.com. We've got great prices on singles, boosters, sealed boxes, sleeves, and anything else you need to take home the win at your next PTQ or at your kitchen table. Don't get lost in a labyrinth of online shopping. Just try channelfireball.com.
Hey guys, Sam Pardee here, back home from the Pro Tour and recording a little M15 draft. We have a pretty easy first pick here. Not only is Nissa very, very good, it's also the most valuable card in the set. But even if like this was a Pro Tour draft or whatever, I would still just certainly take Nissa. None of these other cards are powerful enough to warrant taking over a 5-mana 4/4 trample that might get you another 4/4 trample. Like, even just that alone is powerful enough to be worth taking. If it wasn't in the pack, I think I would take Lightning Strike. I like red pretty well in the format, and this is a pretty weak pack other than the Nissa and the Lightning Strike, I think. These other cards are not very good, but we're happy to have a Nissa. Alright, so this pack has Jurubi Murk Lurker, which I think is an excellent card. But it is two colors, neither of which are Nissa, because obviously it's not good as a 3-mana 1/3, and if you're just black, you can't even cast it. It's a fine kind of card to splash. Usually I prefer to splash, when I splash a card like this, I prefer to splash the black part rather than the blue part, even although either is really okay, just because then even if you don't draw your swamp or whatever, you can just play it, and you have a 3-mana 1/3, which is not great, but is not. Not horrible. So I think that's the best card in the pack. Cursed Spirit is okay, Divination's okay. I think the card I want to take though is Netcaster Spider, which is one of the better green commons. I think probably the best green common maybe. But anyway, very good and stays on color, so pretty easy pickup I think. All right, here it looks like we're gonna have to go off color a little bit. We have Evolving Wilds, which I actually like. I really enjoy just having a few Evolving Wilds in my deck, and then I can splash. If we pick up a Sunblade Elf, we can splash white. If we pick up a Curd Chieftain, we can splash red. All that sort of stuff. And that might actually be the pick, because this pack is pretty weak. I guess Borderland Marauder is probably the next best card. Aeronaut Tinkerer and Turn to Frog are both okay. But I'm not super thrilled about either. Turn to Frog is a little weaker in this format than it might otherwise be because there's a lot of auras and plus one counters with like Living Totem and all the various white auras. So weakens the card a little bit. Borderland Marauder is just a great card. It's basically Gorehouse Chainwalker that sometimes can block, so that's pretty good. I think that's what I want to take. It's between that and Evolving Wild in my mind, and yeah, probably just Marauder and see if we end up, see if that color ends up being open. So here we have Forge Devil is pretty good, but the card I want to take is Hunt the Weak. It's not hard to set this up to, kill a guy and put a plus one counter on your guy, which is pretty much awesome for 4 mana. And if if you have a green deck, usually you have some weaknesses to things like Accursed Spirit or Flyers. Basically, random evasion creatures. So, yeah, a little green removal never hurts anyone. Forge Devil's also excellent. There's a lot of Welkin turns and whatnot that are worth killing. But I think trying to stay, cut green as hard as we can is a good plan. So here we have Wall of Mulch, which I find to be quite underrated. Just a 2-mana 0/4 is great, it blocks everything. And then Living Totem, which I also think is quite good. It requires you to have a fair number of 2-drops because you really don't want to spend the full 4 mana for this, although when you do, it's not a disaster. I think I'm going to take the totem just because I think it's a little bit more powerful than Wall of Mulch. Titanic Growth is just fine. Usually in my green decks, I want to start about one Titanic Growth, and I'm pretty sad if I have to start the second, and I'm pretty happy if I get to cut the first. So I'd prefer not to take it early. Ooh, Elvish Mystic is perfect. I think this is probably the best green common, and then Netcaster Spider. But this card's just fantastic. Casting turn 4 Nissa is great. Casting turn 3 Netca or turn 2 Netcaster Spider is also great. Just Everything about the card is great. Broodkeeper is probably the most powerful card in this pack, but I'd rather, like I said, cut green as hard as possible, and then we'll figure out a second color maybe in pack two, or if we get a late removal spell in any color, we can just move in on that. All right, so here we have no good green card in this pack. Vine Weft is pretty horrible, and Back to Nature is a fine enough sideboard card, but it's not super exciting. The two cards that I like are Heliod's Pilgrim and Thundering Giant. I think Heliod's Pilgrim is pretty strong, although green is one of the weaker colors to pair it with because I don't think green has any good auras at common. So I'm just going to take Thundering Giant to stay on color because we do have the Borderland Marauder. And we can be a nice little green-red beatdown deck. Ooh. I think Gather Courage is the best pump spell, and Invasive Species is just a solid card. It's actually a pretty tough pick. Given the way things are shaping up, Hunt the Weak makes the Gather Courage a little better, and Invasive Species is not at its best in a beatdown deck, which red green tends to be. So I think I'm going to take Gather Courage. Not 100% sure about that pick, but it might work out. So here I just want to take Verdant Haven. It could help enable a splash if we end up wanting one or whatever. Wall of Fire and Marked by Honor are the two other playable cards in this pack, and that's stretching the definition for Wall of Fire. But I think we'll just take the card we might start. Naturalize is a good sideboard card, better than Clear a Path for sure. Oh, Ranger's Guile is a perfectly startable card. So is Crowd's Favor, but I've grown to dislike it more and more. It loses to basically every other trick, so it's nice that it's very cheap. But if your opponent has another trick of their own, you get blown out pretty bad. Also, I think it's more likely that we end up green than that we. I mean, we're guaranteed to end up green. We might not end up red. Although, right now, we have two red cards. So, by that same token, I'll take this guy. He's not great, but he's kind of a crawl worm or whatever, if that's what you need. Sometimes your deck just wants a crawl worm. This is also not the worst trick of all time. I don't like to main deck it, but it's a when you bring this card in, it's usually very good. If they have like the white deck with Glorious Charge or whatever the card's called, the +2/+1 for 5 mana, this card can be quite a blowout. All right, so got a few good options here. Obnixilis is quite strong, and I think green black is a very powerful combination. It's not hard to get him huge in a deck like that. And we could play Verdant Haven to help enable casting him early. Reclamation Sage is also great. There's a lot of main deckable artifacts in this set, and most white and red decks have a couple auras. They'll either have Hammer Hand or Inferno Fist or the like Marked by Honor or whatever. So it's pretty easy to make Reclamation Sage good. Siege Worm is a card that I think I value lower than most people. It's always just sort of been a big guy. It's pretty good when it's good, but I don't think it's amazing. I think the card I want to take is Reclamation Sage. Although, man, no, actually, I'm going to take Obnixilis. I think Obnixilis is more fun and potentially more powerful if black ends up being open. Speaking of which, here's a Covenant of Blood, which I think is an excellent black card. Probably better than Accursed Spirit in a deck like this. We already have two super powerful cards, so just having some removal would be very good. Blastfire Bolt would probably be the next best card for us. We don't really want another Hunter's Ambush, and I think Wolf Forge Golem is just pretty bad. So we'll take Covenant and not be unhappy about that. So I'll put our red cards and our black cards in two piles so we can evaluate. Ooh, wow. This pack is great for us. We have Elvish Mystic, Netcaster Spider, Hunt the Weak, and Nightfire Giant, which would be a very is a very, very good card to splash, because it's a 5-mana 4/3 is not horrible, and a 5-mana 5/4 that has Nightfire's ability is amazingly good. However, there are so many good green cards in this pack that I just want to take one of them. It's just a question of determining which. I think we probably just want Elvish Mystic. We have some great fatties to be casting, and a few 3-drops to be casting early. And these ones are a little more replaceable. Like, if we end up with 2 Elvish Mystics and instead of 2 Netcaster Spiders, a Netcaster Spider and invasive species, it's not that much worse. Whereas the difference between having 2 Elvish Mystics and one is pretty huge. So I think we'll take that. Alright. I like Shadowcloak Vampire quite a bit, actually. It's basically a 5-mana 4/3 flying. The life loss is not usually that relevant. I don't love Scrapyard Mongrel in a deck like this. We don't have any artifacts yet, and in green red it has to compete with other green creatures, where normally in like red blue or whatever it's gonna just be the best 4-drop available to you. So I think I'd rather just move in on black. Okay, here we have Phytotitan, which is okay, but not amazing. Satyr Wayfinder, which I think is great. I think this card is so much better than it was the last time around in Born of the Gods or Journey into Nyx or whichever set it was in. Just because there's a lot more X ones. Like there's Childs of Knights, there's Necromancer's Assistance. There's a lot more creatures that it actually trades with. There's a Reskos Swiftclaw, so I think it's very good. Evolving Wilds would also be fine if we wheel that Nightfire Giant. It'd be good to have, but I think we just want the Wayfinder. Also, we have a couple sixes and, you know, we can convoke this Covenant of Blood with it, so it'll help us get to there. All right, Rotfeaster Maggot is quite strong. It goes well with our Satyr Wayfinder also, so that would be a good one to have. I'm going to move the red cards to our sideboard now, as I think we've moved fully into green black, which is one of my favorite decks. So, yeah, I'm just going to take the Rotfeaster Maggot for sure. I don't love cards like Child of Night just because, like I said, I think Satyr Wayfinder is good, which means Child of Night gets to be pretty bad, especially against like Raise the Alarm tokens or whatever, Forge Devil. There's a lot of ways that X1s get punished, particularly 2/1s. They can't attack through Research Assistant even. I think Zofshade is acceptable but not amazing. The card I actually want to take is Plummet. I think this is a format where Plummet has gained a lot of value, and I usually am not sad to main deck the first one, and I'm always happy to have them in my sideboard. So I'm just gonna add that one to my sideboard right now. Ooh. I think so the picks here is between Restock and Invasive Species, and I think we want Restock. If we pick up a few more Satyr Wayfinders or Necromancer's Assistant, then this becomes just, you know, we can be tutoring for our Nissa's and Omnixiluses and whatnot by milling them and then restocking, which is just great. And the card is just very good value overall, so that's what we'll take. Invasive Species would certainly be good too. Ooh. Here we have Seedworm and Typhoid Rats. Both pretty appealing options. I think we will go with the rats, because we're a little removal light and our curve's a little heavy right now. We have a lot of fives and sixes. So the rats will help balance that out and let us survive. I guess we'll take a Moss Beast for our sideboard. Another Rotfeaster Maggot. Probably gonna go in the sideboard. I think we have enough five drops right now that we don't need more. Although I'm happy to play with this Elvish Mystic and Verdant Haven combination. We should be able to ramp into these fives fairly frequently. I don't think we need another Moss Beast, so we might. If our mana ends up insanely good somehow, we might play Radiant Fountain, but it's very unlikely. So we get a couple more blanks.